This is one of the darkest slot canyons I've ever been in. This section of Leprechaun Canyon, near south of the San Rafael Swell, between San Rafael Swell and Lake Powell on the Colorado Plateau in southern Utah, just has some really impressive, narrow, and deep slots, which are just really impressive. We'll walk down a little further and maybe talk a little bit about how these slot canyons form. So slot canyons generally form when you have a certain set of conditions, and those conditions would be having a rock type that's homogeneous. So in this case, we have this sandstone that's all uniform grain sizes. The sandstone weathers at the same rate. There's not soft layers and hard layers. And that allows, as the erosion continues, it allows the erosion to cut deep and down into the canyon. So one part of the recipe is having a rock type that's homogeneous. It's pretty much made out of the same stuff, no inconsistencies, no hard parts, soft sections, that sort of thing. The second part of the equation would be to have a fairly steep gradient. So we need to have an area where the topography is steep enough that as that water moves, it has enough erosive force to cut downward through the layers. This section here is really quite exquisite. It goes from being narrow to a little larger, a little more cathedral-like, probably because the rock layers are a little bit, maybe a little bit softer down here, almost like a subway tunnel. And then the third part of the equation is having the right climate conditions for heavy downpours of rain that you can concentrate and funnel into these narrow canyons. And so here in the Colorado Plateau, they have a monsoon season that runs from July through August into early September. And when they get these types of flash flooding events and intense thunderstorms, all that rainwater is channelized into these slot canyons. There's not a lot of vegetation or soil to soak up the water. And so that water just gets channeled into the canyons, and it carries rocks and sand with it. And the rocks and the sand are actually the tools that actually cut and excavate deeper into the sandstone itself. And so it's a pretty rare combination to have those things all coming together. And that's why slot canyons are somewhat rare. You only find them in certain areas. Here, as we kind of look downstream, we can see, this kind of wider area here, maybe like 20 feet or so wide, but it's starting to cut a secondary channel into the floor of the sandstone here. So this is kind of how these would form initially. You can see some of the harder rocks kind of wedged in the bottom. So whenever there's enough water down there, those get moved around. You can see some of the flutes and channels, some of the really beautiful shapes we see in the floor of the slot canyon. And if we come down a little bit further, we can see again, kind of where it's starting to cut a deeper channel again. So really quite remarkable here, these slot canyons in southern Utah, and kind of some of the geology that goes on here. And this is all in the Navajo sandstone, the Jurassic age sandstone that formed when there was a big sand dune environment that stretched from Mexico all the way down to or all the way north to Canada. So throughout Utah, eastern Idaho, Wyoming, parts of Montana, parts of Arizona, Nevada. So we're kind of coming out to the end of the canyon here, but just wanted to share a quick little video about the beautiful slot canyon here at the lower end of Leprechaun Canyon.